Hey, today we're going to talk about keeping moving forward and maintaining momentum right now on the front.
Thanks for tuning in to Lead the Teams, the front.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of The Front. My name is Mike Phillips, and I will be your host. As always, you can cruise on over to leadtheteam.tv and subscribe to my YouTube channel there, please. Also, the audio podcasts are on Google Play, on iHeartRadio, and on iTunes. And as with every episode, whether it's audio or video you're tuning into, please participate in the comments down below. Share your thoughts, share your opinions, ask questions, as often those lead to a really excellent future show. So today I am talking about maintaining momentum and keeping moving forward. This inspiration came to me in our kickboxing class this morning. My wife and I take a kickboxing class together every Wednesday morning, and it is absolutely a blast. But just like anything else, especially going to the gym, sometimes it's tough to get up and get moving. I even asked this morning, I said, are we sure we're going to the gym? And she says, yes, I'm positive we're going to the gym. So we get there and we've done our warm up, we've done our workout, our initial workout, and then we cruise on into the kickboxing class, and we start the warm up for kickboxing, which we start by running in a circle, and then high knees and butt kicks, and you know, traditional warm up stuff when you're headed to the gym, kind of calisthenics, get that heart rate up, start pumping a little bit, and then we get into the rest of the class. Well, at the very beginning of class, I have one of the gals ask me, I was kind of speed walking rather than running, because it was one of those mornings for me. And so as I'm cruising along, she says, and she's being really positive towards me. She says, hey, come on, Mike, you got to keep going. Don't stop. And I looked at her and I said, you know, just because I'm moving slower than you doesn't mean I've stopped. And then it hit me. I was like, man, that is so relevant to business, our business environment today. Because especially as managers and leaders, we want everybody moving the same speed that we are. Like, let's go, let's go, let's go. Pick it up. We got to rock and roll. And sometimes you have to realize that, especially if someone may need more work in an area, or they're struggling in an area, or they're struggling for the day, that it, just because they've slowed down, or even if they're headed in a different direction to, or taking a different tack to accomplish a goal, it doesn't mean they've stopped. It doesn't mean they've quit. And so it's good to encourage people to just remind them, hey, you got to keep going. Let's go. It's not always good to force them to go the same speed that you are. Keep in mind, the reason you're a manager or a leader and you're in the position that you are is because of experience. You've gained that experience over time. If you think back, like for me, when I first got into sales, and I love sales. I think sales is what makes the world go round. When I first got into sales, that there were some struggles. I mean, that the advantage that I had is, fortunately, for whatever reason, I didn't even know why I was selling. I started out selling cars. I didn't even know why I was selling cars. It was just a matter of that I was able to connect with people. And fortunately, people, for the most part, liked me. You know, I had a good way in talking to folks, but I didn't have a process that I followed. I didn't know anything about the cars. If you think back, and so it made it a much longer and more painful process for my customers, because, and they stuck with me because they're like, hey, we like you, but man, this guy, he doesn't know the process. He doesn't know how to make it to the end. He doesn't know about the product necessarily that he's selling us. When you think back, if you got started, whether you got started in sales or in business, or you started as a coach, or you started as whatever area you're in, a BDR, a receptionist, I'm talking about things obviously that are all in the auto industry. But when you get started, you know, take reception, for example. If someone's just getting started as a receptionist on a switchboard, they've got all these buttons and all these different places to transfer it to, and all kinds of different you know, paperwork that they've got to accomplish. And over time, you get in a rhythm. You understand, you know what buttons go to what department. You know what buttons go to what individuals. You know what pieces of paper and what articles and what things go to each department or individual. And same thing in sales. Over time, like for myself, as I developed more in sales, then I learned what the process was, that you start out by greeting somebody, then you figure out their needs, then you show them the product, right? You don't just meet someone, show them the product, and then go, oh, hey, this isn't going to work for you. It helps streamline things. And there is no replacement for experience in business. There's no replacement for experience in anything. Experience in athletics, experience in being a mom or a dad. You know, when you get your first child, for example, you have this brand new baby and you have no idea. And then by the time you get to the third one, you know, they're rolling around on the ground in the dirt and you're like, yeah, that'll wash off. You're okay. So there is not a replacement for experience. And so we have to remember, getting back to my original discussion, as a manager or a leader, just because somebody else is moving on a particular item or a particular task or working on a particular goal that you're asking them to, and they may be doing it more slowly or what you perceive as less effectively, just because they're moving slower does not mean they've stopped. They haven't given up. Give them the encouragement. Maybe do it alongside them. Work with them. Show them those little things that you've learned over the years that you say, hey, here's a positive shortcut or a manner in which you can do this and it'll still garner you the proper results and it won't take so long. You know, teach that to them. There's a lot to be said about real leadership and mentoring and investing in somebody, caring about them so that you can improve their ability and improve their life, improve their outlook, you know? Now it's different if somebody has become stagnant, if someone has stopped, if they have straight out given up, then it's a lot harder to get started. We were talking about this in business last week. If you have not read John Maxwell's book, The 21 Irrefutable Laws of Leadership, I highly recommend pick up a copy and read it because it is still as relevant now as it's ever been. And one of the rules, I don't remember what number it is, but it's one of my favorite rules, is the law of the big mo, the law of momentum. And so once somebody's stopped, if they've stagnated, it can be really tough to get them going again. You got to get behind them and get pushed. It's just like me getting ready for the gym this morning. If my wife had not insisted that, oh yeah, no, we're going, like that's the norm, I probably would have been just content to stay home and do something else. Enjoy a second cup of coffee, right? Try and wake up a little bit more. So the thing is, once somebody's stopped, it takes a lot of energy. It takes a lot of resources. It takes a lot of positivity and encouragement to get them rolling again. Even if it's a slow start and you get behind them and you help push them along, once they're going, they can maintain going. You know, and again, don't be so worried about the speed. Be worried about that they are completing the task. Be worried about that they're doing it well. You know, there's a time and a place for speed. There really is. I'm not saying, oh, hey, just let them do it at their leisure. That's not the point. That's not the message. There is a time and a place for speed, especially in today's environment. I mean, everything is just moving 90 miles an hour. At the same time, there's also a lot to be said about encouragement of somebody and really helping them to learn a task well and keeping nudging them along and keeping going. And like I said, that inspiration this morning, I'll repeat it again. When I said, you know, it was a gal's running, she says, come on, Mike, let's go. And I said to her, I said, hey, just because I'm moving slower than you doesn't mean I've stopped. You know, so I was still getting warmed up and I'd done a whole warm up before that. And that's one of the things too. You don't maybe know what things that your person in business, that your employee has done leading up to that point that has caused them to slow down, either out of being weary or being cautious or whatever the reason may be. Sometimes you as a leader have to slow down and ask more questions, ask better questions, say, hey, why is it that you're slowing down on this part? So, you know, it's all about keeping going. As long as somebody's going in generally the right direction, encourage that. Keep them going in the right direction. Keep them learning. Keep being inspiring to other people. There's a lot to be said for a leader being inspiring to other people. People, when they're inspired, will do just a ton more than when they're not. If they're just showing up to that main mundane job and doing the same things over and over again, and they're not inspired, then it becomes stagnant. You know, I was talking about that in my last episode. So if you didn't watch that one, tune in and check out episode 32 of The Front, right? There's my shameless plug. So thank you very much for tuning in today. Also, I got to show you this. I'm going to wrap on this. Well, I'm not going to wrap on this, but I got to show you this. So if you're listening to the audio version, you need to cruise on over to YouTube and at least watch this part. I'm at what? About 10 and a half minutes or so. This is like the coolest shirt ever, right? My Colorado flag Millennium Falcon shirt. So it's neat. I'm a big Star Wars fan, so I figured I would share it with you guys. So again, keep in mind, just because somebody's moving slower does not mean they've stopped. It doesn't mean they've become stagnant. They're still moving. They're still growing. So make sure you take the time to encourage that. Be an awesome leader. Be an awesome manager. Put yourself out there. Make sure you're inspiring to people. Until we talk next, I hope you have an absolutely fantastic day. Thanks so much for tuning in to another episode of The Front.